Hello students, welcome to lecture number 10. Today we have got a combined topic of marketing management and consumer behavior. So both of you will learn this topic combined. Marketing management students as well as consumer behavior students means semester number 4 and semester number 5. So our today topic is based on some models. And the name of these models, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 models, combinedly they are called micro models of consumer responses. Why this name has been given to these models? Because these models are concentrated only on consumers. That's why they are called micro models. How consumers are responding to our advertising and marketing campaigns. So that's why we have given a specific name to these models, micro models of consumers response. And I told you that in this series of models, we have got 4 models, IDA model, and then the name of second model is hierarchy of effects model. Number 3rd model is innovation adoption model. Model number 4 is communications model. All these 4 models are called micro models of consumers' responses because all of them are explaining how we are targeting our customers by different medias, by our communications, by different methods of promotions, and how their positive or negative response is building up. That's why we are calling them micro models of consumer responses. All these models are majorly passing through 3 stages. Stage number 1, cognitive stage. Stage number 2, affective stage. Stage number 3rd and final, behavior stage. In cognitive stage, because of our message, because of our promotion, because of our ads, communications, because of advertisements, publicity, a process is going on in their minds. It is mental process going on in the minds of the consumers. That's why this stage of all 4 models is called cognitive stage. Second stage is affective stage. How these messages, how this specified message or ad is affecting the consumer. In stage number 3rd is behavior stage. What is his final behavior? Whether he is purchasing the product or rejecting the product at all. So that's why we have divided this series of models into 3 stages. A customer, when we are promoting a product, when we are advertising a product, being a marketer, we are promoting them step by step. We are trying to build up his mentality. Then we are trying to grab his attention and his interest and desire. Then we are trying to make our customer to purchase the product at the last stage. So these are 3 major stages. I have told you their names. The name of model number 1 is IDA model. With this model you are familiar. I have taught you this model in 1 or 2 semesters. Then the name of the second model is hierarchy of effects model. Number 3rd is innovation adoption model. Number 4th is communications model. So we are going to explain them one by one. Now coming to model number 1, that is called IDA model. First of all, you should know that this IDA is an abbreviation of the name of this model. A, attention. I for interest, D for desire, and A for action. Attention, interest, desire, action. This is the model which we are calling IADA model. So this model is divided into three stages: cognitive stage, number second, in affective stage we have got two things, two activities or two functions of this model, interest and desire, and in the final stage, behavior stage, we have got action. Attention stage, obviously, when we are advertising a product, we want to grab the attention of our customers. So that's why it's called attention stage. For this purpose, I have told you before in some classes that we are using different techniques, different methods, different types of media, print media, electronic media, social media, publicity, publicity stunts, sale promotion by offering them different small gifts. So all these methods are used to grab their attentions, to convert their attentions towards our product or service or whatever we want to deliver them. That is called attention stage. And in attention stage, obviously something is going on in their mind. Mind process is going on. Then after this stage, we want to promote their mentality so that customers show interest. To create interest in the minds of the customer, when interest is created, then we are trying our best to create desire in his mind for our product. Then when desire is created, then this series, this stage is reaching to the final stage, behavior stage. He is taking the action. Action means he is purchasing the product practically. So this model is called IADA model. We are trying to grab their attentions towards our product. Then by explaining the product features, prices, all these things, etc., 4 P's of the product, to create interest. And when interest reaches to maximum level, obviously desire is created. Then he is arranging money with the desire, demand is created, and finally he is purchasing the product. So this model is called IADA model. IADA model, I told you that IADA is an abbreviation of attention, interest, desire, and action. Very simple model. We have explained this model before. Now moving to the second model of micro models of consumer responses. The name of this model is hierarchy of effects model. Hierarchy. When we are translating into our local languages, hierarchy means silsilae maratib. Silsilae maratib, what does it mean here? Hierarchy of effects model means how this effect is moving slowly and gradually, step, by stages. That's why it is called hierarchy of effects model. In hierarchy of effects model, in first stage, we have got awareness and knowledge. And second stage, we have got liking, preference, conviction. This was the affective stage. And final stage is purchase. Now let's explain them. I told you that we are moving the consumer mentality or consumer belief about our product or service through our promotion step by step. That's why it is called hierarchy of effects model. You saw here that first we are trying our best to create awareness. Awareness in the society, awareness in the minds of the customer about our product, for example, about the price, about the quality, about the attributes, about the internal structure of the product, quality of the product, price of the product. We are creating awareness. With this awareness, knowledge is building up in the memory of the customer. When we are creating awareness, automatically this awareness for the customer builds up his knowledge. But the game is not stopped here. This, we are trying our best to bring our customer from this cognitive stage to affective stage.
so that he should like our package of 4 P's, product, price, place, promotion, he should like it. But liking is not our goal. Our goal is moving downward, step by step. Then we are further targeting the customer by further explanation, by further details, or by continuously bombardment of the customer with our ads, with our information. Slowly and gradually, we will convert this liking to preference. Here, preference means that he will also prefer this product to other people in the society. Preference is created. He will also prefer this product in the society, plus he will give preference to your product as compared to other products. Then only preference is also not enough or sufficient. We want to achieve his strong belief of positivity. To achieve his strong belief of positivity regarding our product, that is called conviction. Conviction means that his belief is, he has created his belief in our product and service. Then when we are done with this thing, the result of this stage will be purchase. He will purchase the product. When he is purchasing the product, it means that you have reached your goal. So you saw here that this effect was moving up step by step. We were pushing the mentality of the customer step by step. That's why we are calling it hierarchy of effects model. Next is model number third, is innovation adoption model. In innovation adoption model, obviously all of them we have divided into 3 stages, but these 3 stages are further divided into some 4 or 5 stages, sub stages. Stage number 1 is awareness, major stage of cognitive stage, major activity of cognitive stage. Then in affective stage we have got 2 things, interest and evaluation. And in final stage again we have got 2 things, trial and adoption. So awareness, obviously I explained here before that first it is important to create awareness in the society about our product or services. You can use any method of awareness in the society based on the structure of your organization and based on the nature of your organization, plus based on the context of the society. Like if the society is highly educated, internet, all these facilities are available, so people are giving preference to social media. If the society is rural area, people are not having access to social media or print media, then we are using traditional electronic media, radio and television. So we are, however, we can use any method based on the context of the society, based on the nature, education, all these things, facilities available to us and to the society and consumer. However, we are creating awareness in the society. With creating awareness in the society, we are trying our best to build up interest of the customer. Customer should show interest in our product. When he is showing interest in our product, this interest will be developing day by day, and he will evaluate our product based on some criteria. Famous criteria are price, quality, attributes of the product. What is meant by attributes? Attributes means the demanded characteristics of the product. I'm giving you an example. Like, I like a mobile which is slim, with large screen, average price, good camera. So these are my attributes. Demanded characteristics of a product by a customer are called attributes. They are not general characteristics. They are specified characteristics, specified by a specific customer. Aslam likes to purchase a mobile with small size, high memory, good camera. So these 3 characteristics are called attributes of Aslam. So based on the attributes, this customer is evaluating the product with other competitors' product or products available in his excess in the market. Then when you are done with this evaluation, customer is convinced, then he is trying to try that product. He is trying the product on trial basis for a specific period of time. When the trial period is having good effects, or the customer is having good experience with the product, then he is adopted by your product, then he likes to adopt your product, he likes to purchase your product. So this model is called innovation adoption model. And final model is communication model. How our communication, or means organization, how our organization communication is having impact on the mentality of the customer, or how we are making a customer to purchase our product by our communication. This is called communication model. Obviously, exposure is there. You are exposing the product to the society by the means of different media, television, radio, newspaper, billboard, pole signs, Facebook, all social media. Then customer is receiving this exposure of the product through five senses. He is listening, he is watching, he is talking, obviously, he is feeling. Then he is getting cognitive response. Some mentality is building up with your this exposure in the minds of the customer. Something is going on. Process is started in the minds of the customer. He is filtering this exposure in his mind based on different standards and criteria available in his filter, which is in his mind. Then his attitude is built up, whether he is accepting the product, he is rejecting the product, what is he is building up his attitude or mentality, positively or negatively. Then based on this attitude, he is making a decision or he is taking an intention, and then after that, finally he is purchasing the product. So we saw here that these four models are having same characteristics, a little bit different from each other, but combined we are calling them micro models of consumer responses, which we divided into three different stages. So students, this was our today lecture, combined lecture of marketing management and consumer behavior. Listen to my lecture very carefully again and again. Stay at your homes and be safe. Khuda Hafiz.